Welcome to Hot Coffee to give us his post-fight assessment of the Pacquiao-Marquez bout. Veteran sports analyst Ronnie Nathanielz. Good day to you,
Good
Ronnie.
Good day, Karen. Nice
All
to
right.
be with you.
Now,
I love your dress.
Thank you. Did Manny Pacquiao really win that fight against Juan Manuel Marquez?
No. As far as I'm concerned, Marquez won the fight by at least 2 points.
All right.
1 or 2 points. Because he had the more accurate punches, the more telling punches. He was able to take all the punches that Pacquiao threw without even wincing once. He did not even flinch. So the Pacquiao power was non-existent. Because Marquez bulked up for this fight, he put on weight and a lot of muscles.
Yeah.
So he could take Pacquiao's punches. And you could see the face of Pacquiao. He looked, what's this?
Nagulat siya.
Nagulat na siya. Ano nangyari dito? You know.
Hindi ganun kalaki si Marquez noon?
No. Hindi kalaki. When he fought Mayweather, he was flabby, fat.
Marquez?
Yeah, Marquez. Nayon, puro muscle. And that made a difference. And they thought that because he put on weight, he will be slow. Hindi. He was fast, actually. He was quite fast, despite the weight, putting on the weight. No, so everything went against Manny Pacquiao in this fight.
Okay.
And sinabi nila, they said he had cramps. Now, this is the third fight that they claim that he had cramps or he was cramping up. Ibig sabihin, there is something wrong with the training. What are they giving him that he cramps? Or what are they not giving him so that he will not cramp? So they have some explaining to do. The trainers, Freddie Roach, the strength and conditioning coach, Alex Ariza, more importantly, has to say something, has to explain why is this boy cramping up.
Okay. All right. Before we continue, Diane Castillejo is on the phone. Diane?
Hi, Karen, and hi, Ronnie.
Okay, Diane, I wanted to ask you, how is Manny Pacquiao? Does it seem like a regular win to him? I mean, you've been covering him every single fight.
Well, it's not really, I mean, it's really a regular win, as you might, in the sense that it's not really the way he wanted to win. He wanted to, you know, hopefully with a knockout, a little bit more, you know, not with, you know, the crowd saying that he didn't win, some of the media saying it's not the way he wanted to win, but, you know, we just left him a few minutes ago. We did a live interview for Umagang Kay Ganda, actually. And right now, he is a little bit tired because he slept about like 4 or 5 in the morning now. Had the Thanksgiving mass with all the Filipino group and his team at the Lion King State breakfast about noontime. And then he watched the whole replay of his fight, Ronnie, in his suite. And he was really staring at it because you know how Manny is. He loves to watch the way he looks after a fight. So right after that, we had our interview for UKG, and I said, "So what did you think?" And he goes, "Well, I think I won." he had the more solid punches and the more telling blows. So he feels that he won the fight after, but he did admit that his timing was off, his balance was off, the cramps in his left leg. It's sort of in the front part of the, like in the shin area, on the left shin. First they said it was in the foot, but now it's like in the shin. As you've been saying, Ronnie, they have actually been doing some exercises in training to try and prevent the cramps, as it has been occurring the last 2 or 3 fights. But it's...
All right, we'll get back to Diane later. Your reaction, Manny Pacquiao said after watching himself, "I really won."
Yeah, he said he really won, but he also said that he had cramps.
Okay.
That his timing was off, his balance was off, his punching was off.
Okay.
You put those three together, how did he win?
Why do you think did he win?
Well, alam mo na, it's very difficult to judge a fight when you're on three sides of the ring.
Okay.
Okay. So they are looking at it from different angles. That's why one judge scored it, Robert Hoyle scored it a draw.
Okay.
Two other judges gave it to Pacquiao, but one judge gave it by the ridiculous margin of 4 points.
Too much?
Too much, far too much.
Okay.
If you called it a draw, maybe we could have lived with it.
Okay.
Know? But we love Pacquiao. We admire Pacquiao for yeah. all he has achieved and all he has done. But our obligation is to tell it like it is. If we saw that he lost, we have to say that he lost. We cannot let him cover up, just because he's Manny Pacquiao and he's a demigod, we cannot cover up the shortcomings, the failures, or the transgressions. we have to call it like it is, Karen. And I honestly believe, Ed Tolentino believes, his first trainer, Rick Staheli, who trained him when he won the first world title, said to me yesterday, no way Pacquiao won that fight. He said, I was at ringside for the second fight against Marquez. He lost that one too.
Marquez believed that. Second fight, Marquez believed he won that fight.
Now, here is somebody who really trained Pacquiao to win a world title saying that he lost the fight. Tony Aldeguer, for whom I have the greatest respect because he's been a boxing man all his life, he said, Pacquiao lost. Marquez won that fight. Bruce McTavish, he's a referee, he doesn't want to get into conflicts and say these things. But he admitted, Pacquiao lost. No way he won the fight. So these are valued judgment from people who know their boxing. Okay. So it's not only us, Ed Tolentino and myself, who say that Pacquiao lost. Many others who did.
Okay. Now, what's very interesting is, Arlene, can we show that they're showing final punch statistics from CompuBox. I didn't know there was such a thing as CompuBox, where you actually measure total punches thrown, total punches connected, jabs thrown, jabs connected. Mm-hmm. Who makes this?
This is some private individual, a private company that does this. So if the judges made a mistake because they are human, this guy could also make a mistake because he's human. Okay. Now, pangalawa, this is not official. This is not recognized.
CompuBox
is not official. It's not recognized. Because if it is, then get rid of the judges. Let's let the computer decide who won the fight.
How does a computer measure?
Well, they press buttons.
Like if Pacquiao hits,
they press one. If it's power, they press another button. That's the way they calculate it. Now, Onyok Velasco lost a gold medal precisely because of a thing like this, because the judges press buttons to show which punch connected and which punch did not.
All right, Diane Castillo is back on the line. Diane?
Yeah, I'm not sure which part you lost my audio. So
yeah, but go ahead. You were saying that Manny Pacquiao believed he was off, but believes he won.
Well, after he watched a video of the whole fight in his room, he was staring at it intensely. So I said, okay, well, so what did you think? And he said, oh, panalo ako after watching. So
okay.
that's what he feels. Oh. And I know you guys were talking about the stats.
Yes, the statistics, CompuBox.
It had, Ronnie, you know, it had like, actually, Pacquiao threw more punches and he had, because that's the way he is, he's a volume puncher. But he also connected more and it said that he had the more strong blows.
Yeah.
Diane,
I'm curious. Usually after a victory, Manny Pacquiao really throws a party or starts singing. You know what I mean? It seems different now.
Sorry, say that again.
After a victory, Manny Pacquiao usually either throws a party, right? Or gets into singing. But it seems that... It's different now.
He didn't really have a scheduled concert right now. He was just supposed to do a drop-by at the House of Blues here at the Mandalay. But, you know, he was tired. He stayed in the locker room like maybe 2 hours because he had 28 stitches. So it took like almost, 2 hours in the locker room. But by the time he got back to the Mandalay, it was like 12 or 1 in the morning. And then, he just spent a lot of alone time. He was reading the Bible. Actually, he was praying.
Yeah,
and just having some very quiet moments with himself, with Jinky, and you know his family and her family. So he just preferred. I noticed because at this fight, Ronnie and Karen, he didn't do any practice sessions for the singing. So parang he was really focused kasi on the fight.
Okay.
So it wasn't too much. It wasn't really a highlight of this particular season. So that's the reason he
Did Manny mention, I mean, given he is so popular, it's the first time that he's ever been booed.
Yeah, well, what he said, his answer to that was that you know, people are so used to Manny Pacquiao dominating the opponent, you know, really just overwhelming them. And he said this time it didn't happen that way. as we saw Marquez to be a really tough hombre. So he said that's probably why. He's definitely not used to that. That was a very different feeling for him.
Okay.
And all the analysts agreed that it was not really the best Manny Pacquiao that we saw, that we're used to, but things happened. He said he was feeling some things, and not one of his best nights, but Freddie Roach admitted that as well. So he's thankful that he got the victory Marquez tonight.
Okay. Thank you so much, Diane Castillejo. Take care, Diane. All right, Ronnie. So go ahead, your take.
You know, for me, if you looked at the face of Pacquiao after the second Marquez fight, he looked like the face of a loser.
The second fight.
Second fight, all right? And he was surprised when he got the decision.
Yeah.
You cannot deny that.
Yeah, I kind of saw that, actually.
This fight, he went to his corner. Buboy Fernandez embraced him.
Yeah.
Normally, Buboy would be raising his
doing
hands,
this.
Screaming.
Yeah. Know?
But this time he embraced him.
Yeah.
That was the embrace of a really close friend to somebody whom he thought had lost.
Oh, wow.
You know, normally when you want to sympathize with somebody, you embrace that person.
Yes.
And to me, that was a reflection of what Buboy thought.
Yeah.
At the end of the round number 7, Freddie Roach said, "Son, we are falling behind."
Yeah, I heard that.
Very clearly.
Yes, yes.
"Son, we are falling behind." He didn't do anything in the subsequent rounds to overcome that. Although in the last round, the last two rounds, you can say Manny really tried.
Yeah, he got more aggressive.
He got more aggressive. Question is, why so late?
Why?
Tell me.
No, I'm curious.
I am also very curious. Why so late? If he had the cramps, how come he moved so well in the last two rounds? Oh, and he became the aggressor. When you do that, the normal reason is that you think you're behind, so you got to establish yourself in the last two rounds to clinch the fight.
Okay.
So he, in his mind, I think, figured, "I'm losing this one. I'm losing this one, so I better do something particularly special in the last two rounds." And that's why he tried so hard.
Now, what happened to Manny Pacquiao? Why did he perform in this manner?
Could be he was overtrained.
Okay.
Normally, Pacquiao likes to train for 6 or 7 weeks.
Okay.
He doesn't like this long training period.
Yes.
So he trained more than 2 months for this fight.
10 weeks.
When you do that, the tendency is you get tight, you cramp up, and you cannot move as well as you would normally move if you had a shorter training period.
Okay.
Buboy Fernandez has always complained about a long training period. Buboy Fernandez, in fairness to him, has always said, you know, with all this strength and conditioning, Samini Buboy, you know, you're not building a bodybuilder to take part in the Mr. Universe contest. You're building a fighter, and a fighter, his main weapon is hand speed. That's Pacquiao's weapon, hand speed. He didn't show it yesterday.
Yes.
Maybe Buboy, in his own down-to-earth practical way, is right. Maybe the strength and conditioning is too much. And he's getting muscle-bound instead of keeping the speed and the smooth-flowing Pacquiao that we knew.
Yeah. No, I'm curious, if we show some photos of the fight, what happened to Marquez that his counter punches and punches were directly either to the face, the body? It was more precise.
Because Nacho Beristain, his corner man, who is in the Hall of Fame, is one of the best, if not the best trainer in the world, with all due respect to Freddie Roach.
Okay.
Okay. Nacho Beristain said, "Don't go with your roundhouse blows. Keep it straight."
Yes,
straight,
he did.
Keep it. In other words, go for the target. Don't go this way and that. Pacquiao, how many times did he lunge with the left hand and miss?
Yes, missed.
Missed. And his lunging means desperation.
Really?
It's a desperate way. You never lunge because you get caught off balance, you can hit with the counter.
Okay.
And Freddie Roach does not like him lunging with the left hand.
But why did Manny Pacquiao have to lunge?
Because he couldn't get to Marquez.
So what did Marquez learn?
Marquez, firstly, he couldn't hurt Marquez.
Yeah.
Marquez obviously had bulked up and could take his punches. That's why Marquez became a little braver later on. A little braver later on by really going after him, after Pacquiao.
Yeah.
And he was very deliberate in what he did. Marquez was very deliberate in what he did. He went for a target and he got it. And every time, if you notice, Pacquiao connected with a couple of punches, Marquez came right back.
Exactly.
Right back to erase the advantage that Pacquiao had.
Wasn't there one moment na kinikwento sa akin na paluhod daw si Marquez? Ano ba yun? Nadapa?
Napaluhod.
What was that?
That was a slip.
That was a slip.
Complete slip.
Oh, it had nothing to do with Manny Pacquiao.
Nothing to do with Manny Pacquiao.
Okay.
It was a slip. And the referee ruled it a slip.
Okay.
So, wala naman yan. That was nothing. That was nothing.
Now, the usual strength of Manny Pacquiao is he's fast.
His speed and his power.
Was it there?
No.
Even the speed?
No.
Really?
No, it was not there. And you have to understand, you know, we're talking about these cramps and all of these things. Look at the progression of Manny's fighting career. Shane Mosley, an old man, went 12 rounds with him. Antonio Margarito, who is a one-dimensional fighter, went 12 rounds with him. Joshua Clotti went 12 rounds with him.
Yeah.
Now, Marquez goes 12 rounds with him, and in my humble opinion, beat him.
Okay.
So, you can see, Manny Pacquiao is not the same Manny Pacquiao of the years gone by. All right?
Yeah.
Okay. The punishment he has taken, you know, he started boxing when he was 16 as a professional.
Yes.
So he's been 17 years in this business.
Yes.
And it's going to take its toll on him.
But Marquez is older.
Marquez is older, but Marquez does not engage in the kind of distractions that Manny Pacquiao engages in.
Okay.
He's not a congressman. He doesn't play pool.
Exactly.
He doesn't bet.
Yeah.
He doesn't sing. He doesn't have night outs. So he's a very different person.
Yeah.
So it's toll.
I saw a documentary on Marquez. He's actually a family man.
Very good family.
Very simple. That's it.
Very simple family man. That's why he heard so much about this fight, that he lost it, because his whole life was staked on this. As Rick Staheli told me, if Marquez goes to his grave, he will go to his grave saying, I beat Pacquiao 3 times.
Even the first fight, you believe he beat Pacquiao?
No, I don't believe him.
Okay.
I thought he lost
all
that
right,
fight.
Okay.
I thought he lost that fight. Definitely he lost that fight. Second fight was very, very close.
Yeah.
You know, I think the knockdown in the third round helped Manny Pacquiao win. Because a knockdown is a knockdown.
Okay.
No matter what you
say. So Manny hit Marquez on the second fight and Marquez was knocked down but stood up.
In the third round. Yeah, stood up right away. In fact, he has been knocked down 4 times by Pacquiao and he stood up. Now you see the progression. First fight, he knocked him down 3 times. Second fight, he knocked him down once. Third fight, he couldn't knock him down at all.
I know.
So, if you look at it in a very logical way, and I think it's a little unfair to look at it that way, but you can see that Manny Pacquiao is not the same Pacquiao is in fight number one or fight
Marquez
number two. Marquez got better. I think Marquez got stronger, but not necessarily better.
Okay. Okay. Now, were there any... It seemed to me, but I'm not an expert, that... One Manuel Marquez knew exactly what Pacquiao was going to do. And before Pacquiao could do it...
He did it.
He beat him to it. Yeah, he beat him to it or prevented it.
Right.
He really studied Pacquiao.
If you looked at the start of the fight, Pacquiao did well in the opening rounds. Because what Pacquiao was trying to do was to invite Marquez to come in so he could counterpunch.
Okay.
Marquez didn't bite.
Yeah.
He didn't bite. Okay. And then after one or two... punches of Pacquiao, he realized this guy can't hurt me. Okay. Then he started punching. He started punching Pacquiao and connecting. And if you notice many times, atras si Pacquiao, he moved back when Marquez came forward.
Yeah.
You know? Which indicated that he was concerned. He was concerned.
Let me take out your override, just excuse me. But go ahead.
Okay.
Go ahead, yeah. Okay.
So he was concerned. And you know, he had a look of concern on his face.
Yeah.
What did I get into? How come this Marquez is like this? Because they expected Marquez to be slower, okay?
Yes.
And that the speed of Pacquiao will tell in the end. It didn't. Marquez was not slower. And the speed of Pacquiao was not there, the speed that we're used to in the past. So I think, to be very honest, firstly, we can't blame Pacquiao. I mean, the judges gave him the decision. It's not his fault.
Yeah.
It's not his fault.
Agree.
I didn't like the booing. Because, you know, Pacquiao has done so much for boxing, I don't think it was fair to boo him.
Yeah.
But I think the gamblers in the Mexicans were the guys who could have made a killing, but they didn't. So they were booing.
Explain that. I think people need to understand Las Vegas as a, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
as a little country when it comes to boxing.
Actually, Las Vegas is the gambling capital of the world.
Okay.
That's the first point.
Okay.
There have been several bad decisions by judges in Las Vegas.
All because of gambling?
I'm not saying it's because of gambling. It could be because of gambling.
Okay. All right.
The other thing is...
What were the odds? If you bet on Marquez...
For 1 peso, you win 10.
Imagine that, okay?
So if you bet a million, you'll win 10 million.
Exactly.
If all of those bets were counted and Marquez got the win...
Yeah, the casinos could have closed or something.
They would have been in deep trouble, and they're already in trouble.
Okay.
You know?
All right. What was the Manny Pacquiao betting?
If you bet 10 pesos on Pacquiao, you'd get one.
Okay. So, yeah. So Marquez was the real money maker
If he won. Now, the other thing you have to understand is the Nevada State Athletic Commission always insists that they name the officials for the fights. Now, this is a WBO fight, but the WBO has no say in the officials. If it's a WBC, IBF, WBA fight, those world organizations who give the belt, who recognize the champion, have no right to name the judges.
Why?
It's Las Vegas.
Yeah.
That controls.
Who were the judges? The guy Hoyle, that gave 4 points.
Glenn Trowbridge, Robert Hoyle, and Dave Moret.
Yeah. Some people were saying, I mean, comments on Twitter, it's actually Bob Arum that won this fight.
Well, Bob Arum always wins the fights. Okay. Because, let's face it, he's a promoter, but he's also a very astute businessman.
Okay.
You know, and the very fact that he refuses to match Pacquiao with any fighter other than a top-ranked fighter tells you something. Because under his agreement with Golden Boy, when they had that conflict over Pacquiao signing two contracts, the agreement, the settlement was that if he fights a Golden Boy fighter, they split 50-50.
Okay.
If he fights anybody else, Golden Boy gets only 7%.
I see.
So that's why Bob Arum, Marquez was with Golden Boy.
Okay.
Okay. Before this fight, Bob Arum told Marquez, you want a third fight with Pacquiao? Marquez said, yes, of course. Then come sign with me.
I see. Okay.
So he signed with him. So he didn't have to share 50% with Golden Boy. Mm-mm. He had only 7%.
Now, what's very interesting is Marquez now refuses to have another Pacquiao fight.
Because sinabi niya, he said, even if I knock him down, they'll pick him up and declare him the winner.
Okay.
That's an overstatement.
I mean, it's a joke, but
it's
I know what you mean.
But I mean, he was trying to get a message across, yes. You know. And he wouldn't want to fight Pacquiao. Maybe after he sleeps over it, maybe for the money, he may want to fight Pacquiao.
Yes. Because clearly, Pacquiao cannot knock him down anymore.
Obviously, he couldn't in that last fight. But maybe if they change things radically, maybe Pacquiao will ultimately do what all of us expected him to do or would wish that he can do.
Yeah.
But frankly, I don't think another Marquez fight will sell. I don't think it will sell. Because
Anymore.
Because, you know, Bob Arum thinks he can hype it and he'll sell it. But most people, I mean, they're kind of sick and tired of Pacquiao Marquez.
They are?
I think so. I mean, especially the Mexicans.
Okay.
I mean, they feel that he was robbed twice.
Yes.
So, I don't think they won.
Could Manny Pacquiao have reacted differently? I mean, in the world of boxing.
I mean, you know, I would have expected him to react a little differently because he's a politician. Okay? And I don't know why the politicians always insist that they win, even though it's Dak Dak Bawas. No?
Okay, all right.
But I would have expected him to say, it was a close fight. I thank the judges for the decision. Don't blame me.
Yeah.
And I congratulate Marquez for putting on a tremendous fight. Tama. He came out and said, I know I won the fight. I really won the fight. But his face didn't show it. Even this morning when he looked at his face, it was glum. It was not the face of a happy, conquering fighter. And remember, Karen, he is the pound-for-pound king. He is supposed to be the greatest fighter of all time. Look at me in the face and tell me, what you saw yesterday, was that a reflection of the pound-for-pound king or the greatest fighter of all time? I'm not knocking Pacquiao.
Yeah.
He probably had an off day. There are so many other things that's conspired for this situation. But let's call a spade a spade.
In that specific fight.
That particular fight. He was sensational against Margarito. He cut him up to ribbons. He was fantastic against Hatton. He pulverized De La Hoya.
Yeah. Hatton?
Yeah,
Hatton. No, that guy was knocked out.
cold.
Yeah, that was humiliating for that guy.
Yeah, and his legs were like that.
I remember that.
Yeah, it was like what Donaire did to Fernando
Montiel. No, but I mean, that Hatton came back to England practically in humiliation. He had to quit boxing.
He wrecked his life. He wrecked his life. He went to drugs. He went to all sorts of silly things.
Are you serious?
Yes. He went into drugs and he said Pacquiao is the one that caused that because I lost. He was so demoralized after
the way he lost. Losing is fine, but the way he lost.
I mean, he was shattered. So he got into drugs. He was caught sniffing cocaine on TV. And in media.
Oh, gosh.
And he confessed. He confessed. And he's undergoing rehabilitation. He was an alcoholic, actually. He used to drink a lot.
Okay. But all right. Now, where do you think should Pacquiao go after this fight?
I think Pacquiao, one, somebody suggested that he clean house. I agree with that 100%.
Clean house meaning what?
Clean house. Get rid of those alipores. Get all of those people. He has 60 people staying in his palazzo, sleeping with him. How can a world champion prepare for a world title fight with 60 people staying in your apartment?
He says he doesn't like to feel lonely.
Well, his wife and kids could be there in the bar. I mean, that's a way to get rid of your loneliness. Family is the best antidote to loneliness.
So you're saying in a loving way, actually, because you love Pacquiao.
Yes, I do.
He has too many distractions.
Too many distractions.
For a
far
boxer.
Too many, yeah. And you know, boxing is a full-time business, full-time job. He's a congressman also. So that takes up a lot of his time. Mm-mm. Fair enough, because he has other aspirations. Fair enough.
All right.
So you put the boxing and the congressman things, fine. But stop the pool playing late at night.
Okay.
Stop the cards and all of the other things. Stop all of that.
Stop. Okay.
Okay. Boxing and Congress, fine, because you got to give him a chance. He wants to try to be a president, fine. I mean, everybody's entitled
to that.
Now,
what about the other women issue?
You know, I always say people who live in glass houses shouldn't throw stones. Throw stones. No. But the fact remains that it must be a distraction if it's true.
Yeah.
Okay. It must weigh on his mind, even if it's not true.
I know what
the
you
publicity
mean.
Must be bothering him, must be getting him down. And it also hurts the relationship with Jinky.
Yeah.
You see?
Yeah. In fact, they had a close up of Jinky after. She was either, I don't know, praying, looking down.
And then she said, thank you, God.
Yeah. And then when they said Manny Pacquiao won, she heard it. The reaction was not immediate happiness.
No, no.
It was like shock.
Yeah, and then she said, thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
I lip read. She said, thank you, Lord. Okay. Well, that's the other thing. You know, he must settle all these issues because he with true or false, it puts pressure on him, it puts pressure on his wife.
All right.
And that's not good for their relationship.
I have another question. If you make Manny Pacquiao lose, hypothetically, in a fight this controversial, doesn't that affect
everything.
Las Vegas as a whole in terms of boxing? I mean, even generating income.
Yes.
Because Manny Pacquiao is a superstar. He's a headliner.
Actually.
I mean, if you make another person win and then Pacquiao loses, no guarantee that as many people will watch.
You're perfectly right. There were nearly 17,000 people.
Imagine
was a sellout
that.
Crowd. 17,000 people. So Bob Arum and company made a killing on the gate now. With Las Vegas and its economy down, Pacquiao is a saving grace.
Exactly.
So when he comes, so many people come there, the high rollers, the fight fans, and everybody. So business is good when Pacquiao is there. Because he's the most popular fighter in the world.
Yes.
That's why when he went to Texas, they got so upset, they made good offers to bring him back to Las Vegas.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
So they're out in a way, they've outbid Texas and brought him back to Las Vegas.
Yeah.
Because he is like a slot machine.
Yeah.
Okay. The coins keep coming out when Pacquiao walks in.
Yes.
He generates a lot of business for Las Vegas.
Yes.
So he's important to them. And there is no other fighter.
I think that's the slight complication with Pacquiao.
There is no other fighter in the world today who is as popular as Pacquiao.
Yeah.
Okay. And that popularity maybe have been kind of tarnished just a little bit as a result of his performance yesterday, but he's still a very popular person.
Okay. All right. I'm going to read this. I'll ask you to comment. Here are the scores the judges gave. It's on graphics. Okay. Dave Moretti scored it 115, 113. Glenn, Throw Bridge had it 116 to 112, both in favor of Pacquiao. Judge Robert Hoyle had it at 114 all. Now, it would seem that the most conservative or the fairest, for in other people's view, would be Hoyle.
Right.
But yet, he didn't make Pacquiao lose. It's still a draw.
Yeah, it's
exactly the same, given Marquez's performance.
Yes. He called it a draw. Well, that's fair enough. But you look at it next to Glenn Trowbridge. Trowbridge had Pacquiao winning by 4 points. This guy had it a draw. Were they watching the same fight?
Okay.
A four-point difference is a major difference in a 12-round fight.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Because that means Pacquiao won 8 rounds and Marquez won only 4.
Okay. All right. And then I want to read this so that you can react. At a post-fight interview, fight promoter Bob Arum says they will push for a fourth fight between the two scheduled in May 2012.
Well, May 5 is a date that Golden Boy and Floyd Mayweather said they will fight.
I see.
Okay. Bob Arum is now saying May 5. Could it be he's going to fight Mayweather?
I have a question. After Mayweather sees Pacquiao's performance in the Marquez fight, will he feel now
confident?
I
have always said, don't say that Mayweather is scared of Pacquiao. He is scared of losing his undefeated record, but he's not scared per se of Pacquiao. And I have always insisted that Mayweather is waiting for the moment he sees Pacquiao slipping, both in speed and power and in movement.
And then go for it. Say, I'll do
call,
it.
Call.
I see. I see. Good one. Good one. All right. Quickly, we don't have enough time, but react to this. Sherwin00700008, Facebook and Twitter. Floyd Mayweather is considered a better counter puncher. Can Pac-Man really win over Mayweather?
Well, honestly speaking, not the way he fought yesterday.
Yeah.
But go back in time a little. If Pacquiao gets the right training, no distractions, no hangers-on, no alipores, no endorsements, no all these stupid things that go on around him, he can beat Mayweather.
Okay. Is that the downfall of many boxers? Give me one example whose downfall in history was...
Rolando Navarrete.
I see.
You don't need to look very far.
Yeah.
He's also from Jensen, by the way.
Yeah. Distractions. Huh?
Distractions.
Yeah. Edgar Allan Castro says, if Manny fights Mayweather, then he'd better cancel... This guy agrees with you. All his concerts, showbiz gigs, and focus. What are your thoughts?
Very correct. Remember, I don't want to knock anybody, but, you know, he has a show on Saturdays. Manny, or whatever that show is called, right?
Yeah.
Now, in the midst of training...
I'm in a TV network.
Yeah.
You mean, okay.
In the midst of training, in Baguio, he drives down to tape that show and drives back. Okay. That's a long, hard drive up and down from Baguio. And even if he's sleeping in the car, you're still going that way. It's bumpy, even though he has the fanciest cars in the world, no? But it's not good for his physical makeup. And Alex Ariza told me, Ronnie, when he trains hard, he should be going to bed at 9:30 at night.
I agree.
But what does Pacquiao do? After a hard day's training, when he should be recovering and resting, he's going out. He goes out. And that's the worst thing to do.
Yeah.
So he's got to straighten these things out.
Yeah.
And somebody's got to put him down, sit him down, and talk to him and tell him, you cannot go on this way. And he's got to listen.
Okay.
He's got to listen.
All right. Now, what are Manny Pacquiao's strengths and weaknesses that have to be worked on for the next fight?
You know, I think this fight was probably an off day. So forget it.
Okay.
Forget it.
Yeah.
Try to go
forget
back.
Forget that.
Forget that. Try to go back and do the same things that you did with De La Hoya. And the same things that you did with Ricky Hatton. Then you'll be all right. He'll be all right. He'll be all right. He'll be perfect.
All right. What's your message? I think, you know what? What's hard with Manny Pacquiao is we all love him.
Exactly.
He brought, of course, glory to the country and honor.
Exactly.
But then as a boxing analyst, it's not like you can, like, cover it up or whatever. You have to call it for what it is.
Yeah. You know, it's difficult. It's very difficult because, you know, Pacquiao started on my show. On Blow by Blow when he was 16, 17 years old. And he was with us for 7 years. So I have a certain fondness for him and an attachment. I love the guy. And I think he's a very humble person. I think he's a great fighter and everything else.
Yeah.
But you've got to tell him. Only friends will tell you what's wrong with you.
Yeah.
Not your enemies.
Yeah.
You know. Okay. So you've got to be a friend and tell him, Tama na, sobra na. Stop all of this. Concentrate. Go back to the Hatton, De La Hoya era
you'll be all right.
Okay. And Manny Pacquiao is not yet too old to quit?
No, no.
Okay.
But he has fought for 17 years. So Ibik Sabin, for 17 years, he's been beaten. I mean, he's been beaten up. His body has taken so much.
Yeah.
That's why he cannot dissipate.
Yeah.
You know, more so, he must protect his body.
Okay. All right. Fabulous. Ronnie Nathanielz.
Thank you so much.
And that's Head Start today. Complete replay of Ronnie Nathanielz interview analysis. 6:30 p.m. tonight on ANC. Watch it. I'm Karen Davila. Thank you so much. I'll see you again tomorrow. Enjoy, everyone.